Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, back again today with another news flash episode. Headline is animal rights activist stabbed woman she thought was wearing fur. This is the so-called animal activist right here, this innocent looking woman. Let's see what the article has to say. A woman with a history of attacks on people wearing fur has been charged with attempted murder for stabbing a woman at a church. The victim was stabbed in the arm twice and once in the abdomen with a kitchen knife in front of children she was babysitting while attending choir practice. Meredith Lowell, 35 years old, was detained at the scene by a witness in Cleveland, Ohio, until police arrived. The victim is still in hospital, according to Police Chief Anne Mecklenburg, and it is not known if she was wearing real fur. Lowell was arrested last year for a similar attack at a branch of Whole Foods. Yeah, where else? When she targeted someone she believed was wearing fur. In that incident, she punched her victim, then tried to stab her because her jacket had fake fur on the hood. She used the serrated blade of a Swiss Army knife and the jacket was cut, but the woman, thank God, was not. Lowell was indicted in January on one count of felonious assault in Cuyahoga County. I hope I pronounced that right. An online court docket shows she pleaded not guilty by reason of insanity last month. The case is pending. Yeah, right off the bat, I have to give that to that lady. Insanity is what she should plead for, because we all know very well how insane and mentally ill vegans are. But check this out right here. And in March 2012, Lowell was indicted in federal court in Cleveland after authorities said she posted on Facebook that she wanted to hire a hitman to kill someone wearing fur. Lowell wrote that she would be willing to pay between $830 and $850, according to an FBI affidavit. That is how much a human life was worth for that lady. $830 to $850. Disgusting. An undercover FBI agent contacted Lowell, who asked that a person be killed with a gun or a knife at a Cleveland Heights library, and that she planned to be there when the murder was carried out, authorities said. So, here you can see it yet again. Vegans do not care about humans at all. Under no circumstance the vegan logic holds up. It makes no sense whatsoever. You have two options. Either we humans are animals or not. According to vegans, we are simply animals.
Human animals.
And then you have the non-human animals, right? So if you look into the animal kingdom then you will see that animals eat other animals. That is standard practice. Lions eat gazelles, bears eat fish. Totally normal. Animals eat animals. But the so-called human animal, out of the vegan logic, out of a sudden is not allowed to eat animals or to wear them in this case. And then the vegans will commit, in their mind, animal cruelty by killing humans. Let's proceed. Lowell told the agent she wanted to set up an animal rights militia and specified that a victim at the library should be at least 12 years old and at least 4 feet tall, the affidavit said. She was arrested in February 2012. So there you have it. She wanted to kill an innocent child that was wearing fur. Under which circumstance does that make sense? Even if that kid would wear fur, and even if that is morally not acceptable, then still you would have to take into consideration that the parents would buy those clothes to that kid. So she is willing to pay a couple of measly bucks to kill a young child. But what is truly shocking, if we proceed, we see those charges were dropped in January 2013, when it was determined she could not be rehabilitated to competency, court record shows. Yeah, that makes perfect sense. We cannot do anything about her, so let her roam free, right? Let her get a serial killer and let her kill innocent children for $800. That makes perfect sense. Thank you very much, court system. But thank God, finally, for the most recent incident at the Presbyterian Church in Cleveland Heights, she is being held on a $1 million bond. So hopefully now, finally, she will get life in prison, because this would continue like this into eternity. We see it already with oh so many so-called animal activists. They're very violent. They're obsessed with torture. If they are not showing you animals being tortured, they are spending their spare time in a slaughterhouse watching animals being slaughtered. There's a real obsession with death and murder, because vegans psychologically are going against their nature. Let's face it, we as humans are hunters and gatherers. Hunting is in our nature. If we remove ourselves from hunting, which we did now in those modern day mega cities, we remove ourselves from an intrinsic part that means being human. Then all of a sudden you are craving violence, violent video games, horror movies, animal slaughter snuff, just to compensate your desire of hunting. This is the truth. This is what is going on here. Those people, those animal activists, are obsessed with death and murder, and therefore they won't shy away from torturing and killing human beings. Veganism is an absolute death cult. It has nothing to do with health. The worst thing that happened is that veganism leaked into the health branch, into lifestyle and wellness. It has nothing to do with it. Health and wellness means a species-specific diet of meat. Veganism is nothing but a religious movement that wants to protect animals. That is it. And even at that endeavor, they are failing tremendously. As a vegan, you're killing more animals than a carnivore. Look into crop deaths. There is no denying it. If you deny yourself your human nature, you will become mentally ill, not only due to abstaining from hunting, but due to abstaining from valuable animal nutrients that you won't get on a plant-based diet. You will deprive yourself of cholesterol, DHA and EPA, and of course B12, and that is a great setup for absolute mental illness, such as in this case. Alright guys, but this is it for today's newsflash episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If so, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, guys, please do so. If you want to support the channel, all the links are in the description box below. We have Amazon links for you. You can head over there, buy whatever you might want to buy, and it doesn't cost you anything extra. We get a small share. That is a fantastic way to support Bobby's perspective. If you want grass-fed beef delivered to your doorstep, butcher boxes for you. And we have CBD links as well. On top of that, guys, consider supporting Bobby's perspective through Subscribestar or Patreon. We have a VIP community there where we have Skype group calls every single week, where we can discuss any topic, no matter if it is health, lifestyle, or nutrition related. On top of that, by joining, you straight away receive your comprehensive nutrition guide. It is an ebook that teaches you the basics of nutrition but goes beyond as well, and is catering to your personal goals, no matter if you're keto, primal, paleo, or even raw. All right, but this is it for today. Thank you very much for your support, guys, and as always, much love and peace.